Thanks for showing up to my impromptu meeting. I know we're all very busy coaches and athletic trainers, but we have a bit of an emergency on our hands.
Did the coach buy off-brand hurdles that are too high so the track team can't clear them again?
No.
Did the mascot get tangled up in your volleyball nets again?
No, nothing like that. It's more serious. I'm worried about the health of our athletes, and the culture of our programs might be sending the wrong message. I brought in a consultant, Dr. Sprite, to talk to you.
Look, I gotta catch them all up, so I'll just fast forward this part for you guys.
But what should we do if we suspect one of the athletes of having red S?
I'm glad you asked. Why don't we go to tape? Lucky for you, the Variation players created some training scenarios for you.
Harris?
Yeah, coach?
You might want to lay off the protein bars. Your pace is glacial. How much you weigh these days?
Strike one!
Let's address a few things here. Never tell an athlete to diet or lose weight. Attempting to lose weight, diet, or talking about calorie goals can lead to eating disorders.
We can't talk about weight. So then how are we supposed to address a concern? Especially since it seems like Harris hasn't been performing that well.
The most important thing to worry about is your athlete's physical and mental health. So if their performance is a concern, try to figure out why. Are they getting the recommended 8 to 10 hours of sleep? Reevaluate your training schedule. Make sure they're not overtraining by spacing high-intensity workouts apart by at least 48 hours and taking 1 to 2 rest days per week.
Hey, Rodriguez, maybe you could give Harris a few pointers.
Strike two!
If you are concerned about an athlete, talk to them in private. Avoid comparing them to each other or with professional athletes, which might promote an ideal body image, because that could lead to disordered eating. How about we take a look at another approach?
Hey, Harris, can I talk to you for a minute? I just wanted to check in with you and see how you've been doing.
Starting with open-ended questions will allow the coach an opportunity to bring up any concerns.
I'm just afraid they won't open up to us.
That's fair. Having a good relationship with your athletes is key. Anyone that has a solid connection and some authority can talk to an athlete. It's okay if they don't open up at first. Athletes with red S often don't recognize that there is a problem. Let's see how the coach does this time.
How are things going?
I don't know. I'm just trying to get faster, so I don't slow the team down. I guess I just need to practice more.
You're one of the hardest working athletes I know, and I appreciate your dedication to the team. You're not in trouble. I'm just concerned about your health. You've dealt with some injuries this year and haven't been the upbeat and joyful old Harris that I know. I would like you to see a doctor to make sure your mind and body are healthy before continuing with your training.
Touchdown!
The coach expressed concern in a non-judgmental way, without asking questions or making statements about weight or eating habits, which could feel threatening. Anyone with weight loss, irregular periods, recurrent injuries, mood changes, or any other symptoms of red S should be referred to a doctor. If they refuse, reassure them that they aren't being punished, but they'll be considered injured until an evaluation determines otherwise.
What kind of doctor are we supposed to send them to?
And how do we refer them?
Yeah, let's say they see a doctor, and they do have red S. What's the treatment?
Can they still compete?
All great questions. After you talk to the athlete, explain your concerns to the parents and ask them to schedule an appointment with the primary care doctor. They may be referred to an adolescent or sports medicine doctor. That doctor will do an assessment and decide if they're safe to practice or compete. Treatment usually involves working with a dietitian and a psychologist to restore the energy balance and address disordered eating. Hospitalization is sometimes required for severe eating disorders, but everything is confidential, so a doctor won't share information unless an athlete wants them to. But wouldn't it be nice if we could prevent any of this happening in the first place?
I wanted to meet before practice today to talk about health and wellness. I've learned a lot lately, and I'm sorry that I didn't emphasize it as much as I should have. I want you to know, your health is the most important thing, even more than athletic performance. Besides, the healthier you are, both physically and mentally, the more successful you'll be. So from now on, we'll be focusing more on emotional health, getting enough rest, healthy sleep habits, and nutrition.
I'm so proud! Educating athletes, coaches, and trainers on the components of the female athlete triad and red S is the best way to change behaviors. Having a dietitian, healthcare provider, trainer, or even a coach talk to the athletes at the beginning of the season is ideal.
How many of you skip breakfast?
I just don't have time for breakfast.
Breakfast is so early.
It's true. About half of teenagers report skipping breakfast.
Our goal is to eat at least 3 balanced meals a day, plus pre- and post-exercise snacks. This will give you enough energy for the workout itself and for your body to recover after. No more skipping meals. I have nutrition guides for you. It will also be posted in the training and locker rooms.
Don't worry, you'll get the pamphlet too.
One other important area we need to pay attention to is your periods. Another consequence of energy deficiency is losing your period or not getting it at all by the time you're 15. If you are struggling with this, please let us know. Now, if you want, I made up what I call the anti-flow chart.
Coach, if you don't mind, I'd like to say something. I'll be honest with you. I'm almost 16 years old and I haven't had a period yet. Recently, I've learned that's not normal. So I've decided to see a doctor and work on getting better nutrition.
Thanks, Mia. Now, if any of you are having a hard time mentally or emotionally, I'm happy to talk with you. You don't have to come to me, but please talk to someone. The athletic trainers, each other, your parents, the school counselor, or a therapist. I know this is all a big change, but I'm asking you to trust me. Will you do that for me?
I will, Coach.
I will, Coach.
Okay, Coach.
Yes, of course, Coach.
Okay, fine, yes.
Yeah! Well, it looks like my work here is done. Make sure you check out our referral information and nutrition handout.